They wanted to make me not to function. Today, if you see the trend, all business leaders who are all not listening to this government, they are attacking. All political leaders who are all differing with NDA, they are attacking. Even media, they are threatening you also. That's why you are also not reporting properly. Be clear. I wanted to make it very clear also. Because I am the senior most leader of this country, you have to remind this. I initiated first time, we initiated my party, my leader initiated National Front. At that time we fought. We were the victims in 1984. Our government was dismissed. Saved democracy 30 days. We fought and revived our government. Then United Front, I was responsible for that. And also NDA, I supported. I was CM in 1995. I promoted technology. I promoted all these things. Today, is it not the responsibility of all of us? What is happening for this country? Democracy is in danger. Institutions are all totally collapsed, defunct, either CBI. What happened recently? I don't want to comment today because it is in the court purview. Supreme Court has given within 2 weeks' time, they have to report back. And also if you see ED, income tax, is there any procedure? Those you don't like somebody, you want to attack them? What is the message you are giving? I am aware tomorrow, day after tomorrow, they will attack me also. What I am saying, if I am afraid, I am not doing justice for this country. Country is important. For the last 40 years, I maintained character. I followed discipline. You have followed me. Never I indulged any pretty politics or pretty things in this country. It is my responsibility to tell the nation what is happening for this great country. Country we are having excellent advantages, demographic dividend. We are very strong in technology. We are very strong in English. Biggest market. Country can grow double-digit growth. We have proved it. In spite of so many problems for the last 4 years, we are able to produce 10.5% average growth rate. There is a potential to grow at the rate of 14 to 15%. We are capable of becoming a developed nation, developed state. We are working like this. They wanted to establish fabricated cases. Yesterday, if you see, they are all hurry in Andhra Pradesh. This airport case on Jagan Mohan Reddy. He went to Hyderabad. From there, he went to hospital. And then he said, all of a sudden, he had a very big injury. Then all these people have joined together. GVL Narasimhrao, Kanna Lakshmanana, immediately governor telephoned to my DGP. Is there any time I'm asking you, governors are interfering in administration? Never. I am CM for 14 years. Sarkaria Commission, you are all aware. We represented in the Sarkaria Commission. We fought for implementation of Sarkaria Commission recommendations in so many forums. Ultimately, we defined governor's role also. At one stage, we made it very clear, you abolish governorship. Because those who are all in center, in power, they will support. Or they are working as secret agents for central government. It is not good. Even today, yesterday incident, they want to destabilize Andhra Pradesh government. Is it right? Immediately for the last so many days we are telling, one is BJP and also opposition leader in Andhra Pradesh, YSR Congress. In Telangana, I differed with Telangana, we are having separate alliance, all these things. Now he joined with YSR Congress Party, even Pawan Kalyan. What I'm saying, you support him, you sympathize him, don't attack me. Because this incident happened in the airport. This is the failure of the central government. Even that knife has gone to the airport, how it has gone? You have to review first, not me. It is not in my jurisdiction. And also you didn't follow the proper procedure also. After the incident, victim left that place without the consent of the CISF. How can he leave? It is his responsibility to report. Even he can take a decision. I'm not interested to pursue the case. That is a different issue. But is it not the responsibility of him as a responsible citizen of this country? There is some crime. That crime has to be reported to the concerned authorities. Immediate authorities there, it is CISF. Everybody blamed me. In what way we are concerned? That they are not explaining. This is where I am saying immediately governor came yesterday. He met everybody here. There are reports he reported to Government of India. What I don't know, what is the report he has given? In course of time it will be established. We have seen all these things in this country. Our party faced so many crises. And at the same time, ultimately, truth is truth, truth will prevail. Even if you see here, government plans, central secretariat in states. From the beginning, we are fighting. Give all the schemes to us. What is the role of central government in states? You wanted to rule everything? You are saying, this is my cooperative federalism. Okay, you want to start all these things. From the beginning, we are fighting. Defense, currency, some issues, external affairs, all these things are with central government. We are nearer to the people. Ours is sovereign government, state government, sovereign government. If you can go through like this, how many institutions they have damaged? Even services also. If you can see the principles what they have brought, majority are from Gujarat, again. Generally, party president and prime minister should not be in one state. It is a sentimental issue. It will be different states to satisfy people, to appear before people that we are unbiased. We will do justice for everybody. Now, majority officers are from Gujarat. All crucial positions. Is it right? Now 360 degree evaluation, they brought it. That means those who wanted to support, they can support or oppose. Even lateral entry also, I am not opposing that. Principle as a issue, principle is good. But implementation, execution. Because of all these things, there is no development, things are not happening properly. And ultimately this government is concentrating only on threatening people and victimizing people and harassing people. Either income tax or ED or some other forces. Ultimately, you have seen what happened in CBI. Who is responsible for that? Today, Rafael. Is it not the responsibility of this government to answer to the nation? He has to answer. Even we all fought on Bofors also at that time. Now it is your responsibility. In this government it is happening. Even the same PM, when he was a CM, he campaigned all these corruption charges throughout the country. Now if I say all these things tomorrow onwards, you can see how many attacks are going to come on me. Every nook and quarter, they will attack me. They will tell you not to broadcast. I am aware of that also. But truth is truth. We have to move forward. We have to save this country. I am here to tell to the nation the truth, democratic values, what this government is doing, and also what all possible as a citizen of this country. I will do my best and I will coordinate, but the way the government is doing is not correct. They have to correct themselves. In this background, I wanted to address this press conference. Anybody is having any questions, I am prepared to answer. Please, ma'am.
What is the outcome of meeting all the leaders that you're here meeting in Delhi, and what is the essential message that you're carrying forward to them? And with elections in the round the corner,
Madam, what I'm saying, if you see here, everybody has to agree, democracy is in danger. And also important institutions you have to strengthen. In the process, institutions are collapsed or demolishing. Second one, secularism.